Hi guys, welcome to the SQL training session. So today we are going to learn how we can load the data from a tab delimited text file and to the SQL Server database table. Okay, so I have opened the SSIS here. I have created one project and inside it I have already one package. So let me create one new package. So right click here and by default, it will be like package one. So I don't want this name. So I'm going to rename it and give the nicer name. Like I'm going to load the tab delimited txt file to the SQL Server. So I have renamed the package. It will it is asking me that you wanted to reload it completely. So yes to all. So the package name got changed. For this we need the file and we have this file employee data tab delimited. So I have only few records in this, and if you see the columns are delimited with by the tab delimited, when we say in a layman language separated. Okay, so this is the tab delimited, perfect tab delimited file. So how you can create a tab delimited file? It's just a simple, you can just type in like let me add one more here. Instead of pressing enter, just press the tab key here, okay, and write give and then first name, and then press tab key, and then like Priya Sharma, let's say, okay, and again press the tab key and give the city name, like let's say Bangalore, okay, and control S, save it, close this file. So this is our source file. We wanted this file to be loaded into the SQL Server database table. Now the destination is SQL Server table. So which table? Employee data table. As of now, do we have any record here? Let's check it. Okay, we have a record. We wanted no. So let me truncate this table so that when we load it, we can get an idea that we can check this table and we'll get an idea. Okay, this package, the data has been successfully loaded. So we'll go back to the SSIS package here. We have opened this particular SSIS package. Okay, we are in the control flow. Here you see the most commonly used task is being present in the favorite section. So for this video, for this session also, we need the data flow task. Data flow task, what it does actually, it is responsible for, you know, moves the data from sources, different sources, to the different destination. Okay, so in this session, for this exercise, we have only one source and one destination. Source is what? TXT file. So let me first of all drag this data flow task. Okay, if you wanted to do, give the name, you can give name load TXT file. It's always a best practice to give a nicer name to your task always. When you double click here, we need to configure it. Now we need to provide the source and the destination. Okay, so on the toolbox, you see the source section, expand the source section, and you know that the file is what is the TXT. So that for it is not an Excel, not OLEDB. So for that, flat file source would be the tool or the item that we need to use. Okay, so now we need to provide connection manager. Okay, we need to provide the connection string so that SSIS package will be able to connect to that file. So for that, there are two ways. Either you can right click here and provide the connection manager from here, or you can simple way, you just double click here and it will ask for the file, flat file connection manager. If it is available in this section, then you can, it will be available in the drop down. It will be, otherwise it will be blank, and there is a new button. Click on new button to create a new connection manager. So as I do not have, I'm not, okay, you can give the connection manager name. Okay, I'll keep it as a blank as of now. Now browse and locate the file. This is the tab delimited file. Okay, I have selected here, and as I know that it is not a Unicode file, so I'll keep this is unchecked. Okay, and this is the tab delimited. So I needed to check this file because I know it is delimited by tab. So first column is the header column, so that we know, so that is why we have make it as a checked. Then we on the left hand side you see the columns. So these are the columns which is we are expecting from the source. Okay, these are the advanced option. You will see the data type and the columns. Okay, output column width, and this is the preview. Okay, click on OK. Click on OK. Now see, and one more things. If you see, this is the columns. Okay, external column and output column. So there are actually the two types of. Some people might get confused. What is external columns and output columns? So external columns is nothing but a column which is present in your TXT file. Okay, and output column is something, the column which is available in SSIS buffer memory. Okay, so you see, this is in file, in TXT file, and this is something the file has put has given to the SSIS package. SSIS package will load the file, first load the file, as you know, load the data in the buffer memory and see if any transformation is required. If transformation required, then it do the transformation and then load to the destination. So there is always a buffer memory in between from source to destination. So for that purpose, we have two different columns here. Okay, source external column is the column which is available in TXT, and the output column is the column which is which will be in the memory. And there is, on the left hand side, there is an error output. This is an option where you can configure your error. Okay, so there are two types of the error in SSIS. Mainly is, first is truncation type error and second is error. And this error, first is truncation and second is data type error. Okay, just in case in Excel or in source file you have different data and destination you have different data. Okay, so that type of error, if you got data type error, so what do you want to do for that error? Okay, so it is saying that in ID columns, if you got data type error, so what you gonna do? Okay, do you want to ignore that kind of failure? Do you want to redirect that kind of rows, or do you want to fail the entire component? You won't let other records also to flow to the destination. So by default, it is the failed component is there. And just in case, if the value in the ID column, the length is 50, 50 is the length. Just in case we expect more than 50 length, so that the truncation would be happened. So in case of the truncation error, what is your call for this column? Do you want to ignore the failure? Do you want to redirect that kind of the erroneous records, or do you want to fail the entire component? So by default, for each of the columns, you see the SSIS package make it as a failed component. So that means if any of the error, any kind of the error, out of two errors, data type error or truncation error, if any of the error in any of the column will come, then the SSIS package will not go ahead. It will fail the entire component. Okay, so I will make a separate video where we will see how we can make configure the error output. Just in as of now, I'll make it everything is by default. Go back here and click on OK. So source is configured here. Now minimize minimize the source part, expand the destination. Now we know that we wanted to load it into the SQL Server table. Okay, for that, what would be our destination? OLEDB destination. Okay, drag it here and first connect the source to the destination and then configure the destination, as we do not have a connection manager for the destination as well. So click on the new button here. Okay, I already have a connection. Let me delete it so that I'll show you how we can create a new connection to the destination. Now it is asking me a server name. So I'll go to the SSMS and this is my server name. So either you can just go here and rename. There is an option. You can right click and go to the properties, and from where you can get the server name. Okay, so it may take some time. So I preferred, you can copy from here. Either you can copy from here, this is one way, and second way, you can connect the database engine, and here, from here, you can copy the name. Okay, so it is completely up to you. Then paste it over here. As soon as you paste it over here, this database is got enabled. So you need to select your database. Our database is SampleDB. Okay, and then click here. Then there is an option to check the connection. Connection succeeded. Click on OK. And then here we want the data access mode is the table, because we know in the file we have the table only. Okay, The name of the table where you wanted to push the data is the employee data. If you wanted to see the existing data in this table, there is an option view data. As of now, we do not have a data in this table. So that is why we got zero records here. Now there is an option. This is very important to map the columns. Okay. Now, so if you remember, few minutes back I told you external columns and the output column. So output column in the source becomes the input column here in the destination. Okay, and the destination column is actually the columns in the SQL Server table. Okay, so you got my point. Source has two columns, two types, external columns and output columns, and destination have input columns and destination column. So input column is basically a column which is coming from the buffer memory, and destination is the column which we have in the SQL Server table. So if you see here the type, if you see this first name type string length 50 and destination is string length 50. This way you can see and click on OK. Okay, we are getting okay. Now we do not have any error here. Now click to execute it. Just click on start button here and wait for a couple of seconds and we'll see. See the results. Three row has been flowed to the destination. If you wanted to see the progress of package, how it has been executed from the very start, so there is a button here, tab here, progress. So it told you the complete story, how it has been gone through, like it has started this first task and then it performed the validation. Okay, then it has check all this thing, and then if you see the SSIS pipeline, or what I call is memory, then total number of row processed, it is 4, because why it is called why it is calling is a 4, because one row is the header row. Okay, so total row is 4, and now we need to stop debugging, go back here and check whether we got the data here or not. Execute. See, we got the 3 records here. Okay, so this way you can load tab delimited text file in the SSIS package. So hope guys you like the video. Just in case if you have any error, so please let me know. Thank you and have a nice day.